Hello everyone, namaste. This is Anand Krishnan here. And to all the first timers who are watching this, I'm an aerospace and defense journalist. Been a journalist for the last 29 years. Primarily, I cover India's military programs. But this broadcast is coming to you with a different purpose. This is aimed at young journalism students, those who are doing their BCJ, MCJ, English literature and other subjects linked to journalism, linked to creativity, linked to writing. So I'm going to start a mentoring program that will be spread across 2 years for all future journalists of India. This program will be something kind of a journalism finishing school. So whatever degrees you get, that has got an X value. Whatever sessions that you are going to undertake with me, that will have an X plus value. Why am I doing this? In the last couple of decades, I have been invited by several universities in India to deliver talk to young journalists, young journalism students. Many of whom are now established journalists in different media houses. I always felt that universities, however inspiring they are, they have limitations. Maybe there is a small disconnect between what an actual newsroom is and what you guys are taught. I'm not trying to blame the syllabus, I'm not trying to blame anyone, but I felt maybe as a working journalist, with whatever little bit of experience I have, I must give it back. So I'm ready to take the role, ready to play the role of a teacher, maybe a mentor. So how do we do this? This will be to start with, considering the pandemic and other still prevalent issues. It'll be an online session. Online session for 1 hour every week. It could be either on a Saturday or on a Sunday. But the timing of this session, I'm very particular. It will be either from 6 to 7 in the morning or from 7 to 8, whatever time everybody agrees upon. Why 6 to 7 or 7 to 8? I want to catch all you guys when you're fresh in the morning. I want to catch you guys when you are not entangled with so many other things. These days, youngsters are surrounded, entangled with so many disturbances. I call them disturbances. Maybe today's generation would want to call some other name, but I feel too many distractions, too many things seeking your attention. Maybe I feel early morning time. I must tell you, as a journalist, I wrote the best pieces waking up in the morning, 4:30, 5. So I want to catch you guys during that time. 1 hour session every week will discuss on various things about journalism, creativity. Also, I'll share with you the lessons I learned from my guru, Guru Kalam, the lessons I learned from my teachers, from mother. So there will be a lot of lessons in about life as well. So it is going to be a mix of creativity, journalism and life lessons. Every session, we will have a topic and at the end of it, either Saturday or Sunday, at the end of it, I will be giving you guys an assignment, a reporting assignment. For the people who want to get into creative writing, they will take this assignment in the writing format. Those who want to become radio jockeys, they will get into the assignment on the radio jockey mode. Those who want to get into television journalism, they will use the camera mode to get. So it will be different kind of assignments. And those who want to get into photography, they will do these assignments through photographs. So there is an option for everyone, whatever you want to take. And remember, those who want to get into scripting, there will be option for them as well. So Saturday or Sunday after the class, you will get the assignment. You will have 1 week to submit the assignment. Every Friday is the day I'm going to fix for the assignments to be submitted. And the format of submission, whether it is going to through email or all those things will be told to you. Once you submit this assignment, I have my friends, senior, very, very senior journalists, experts in editing, copy editing, experts in journalism, gurus of journalism, I can call, whom I revere. They will go through these stories, edit it, get back to you how you can make it a better story. And remember, from Friday to next Saturday, you have time also to interact with me. It is just not that you won't have any interaction. I will be available for this, people who are signing up for this, and to make the story better. How to write a story in a simple format. How to make your story touch people. At the end of it, a good journalist will always be the side of the common man. His and her story. How you can put it out in a beautiful format. All that we will teach you. A reporting assignment with a difference this will be. I have been thinking about this for a long time, and I wasn't sure in what format it will be done. And once the senior team, including me, clears your stories, it will be put out on one particular digital format. What that is not yet decided, but I will use all my social media tools, followed by lakhs of people. I will tweet them, I'll put it on Facebook, I will do, maybe better ones will get on YouTube. It will also get on to Billion Beats, the e-paper of Guru Kalam. And maybe we will exclusively create a blog spot, exclusively create a digital space for all the work to be featured by you guys. It's going to be really, really inspiring. Please note that I'm very passionate about this particular mission, because I feel to take you guys to the next level, why wait for that degree to come to become a journalist? At the end of the day, it is one day, one qualification, you will get BCJ or MCJ, ML Literature, whatever. Why don't you start dreaming? Start getting into that practice mode right away. Why wait for that degree to happen? So this is going to be a laboratory. And as and when this session progresses, I'm sure a lot of ideas will come. But every session you will learn one lesson, one aspect of creativity, one aspect of writing, journalism, and also a little bit of lessons in life. All that I have as a journalist is my struggle. He's the biggest asset I have. I'm keen that, you know, journalism, people say, is dead. And today's journalism is full of noise. People say today's journalism is also fake. Today's journalism is biased. When we all became journalists, when we passionately, like you, youngsters, you know, we were told by our seniors, our gurus, to write straight, to be apolitical, non-biased, take all the views and make a story complete. I must tell you, whoever is following my work, I'm not trying to boast that I'm great, no. But definitely, heart of the heart, I know what, for me, writing is a tapasya. I always remember my gurus, my mother, and everyone who taught me a little bit of things. And my mother was an English teacher, so she was my first news editor. She is no more, but I keep her in all my effort. So this is what I want to tell you guys. And most importantly, this is going to be a professional engagement. So I also need to survive in this difficult world. Post-pandemic, it's a difficult world for everyone. So there will be a professional fee, not too high for you guys. I'm sure most of you can afford it. So that particular payment mode will have to be made through the digital payment. There will be a mechanism put in place. You will have to sign up for a minimum number of classes, and later on, if you like, you can continue. If you don't like, you can discontinue. I am looking at, in a month, 4 classes. That means in a year, you can calculate, it will be close to 50 classes in a year, 50 sessions in a year. And for PG students, 2 years, if you sign up, it will be 100 classes in 2 years. So the number of classes, all that we will decide as we go forward. And in between, when pandemic fears all get wiped out, when people get vaccinated, when the world springs back to how it was before, we will also have periodically workshops. We will have sessions in the middle of forest. We will have sessions in some ships. We will have sessions under the foothills of mountains. So it is also going to be a different kind of experience. And I'm going to, at some different stages, rope in some of the best brains journalism has produced in different fields. You will also get in touch with inspiring leaders, scientists, sportspersons, different people. So if you're ready to learn and unlearn, this is a brilliant opportunity for young journalists. The program, what is coming up, is called as Mission Parivartan. I'm going to name this particular mission as Mission Parivartan, something which I was doing for corporates and others earlier, and then it took some other missions came, so I had to put it aside. But now I'm going to bring it back. Take a look at what a video on Mission Parivartan that was made many years back by an engineering student who completed engineering. His name is Aaron Matthew, and he got on the creativity into film. So Aaron was my shishya. He's still my shishya. So he made this, a Mission Parivartan in small video. Take a look at it. So I hope all of you watched that video, and very exciting times. There's a number for you to WhatsApp me, 7899778888. And you can also email me if you have any doubts at ananta.ak@gmail.com. I hope Mission Parivartan will touch the hearts of many young journalists. And together, we will see how we can take India's journalism, at least in universities, ahead. And when you guys become senior journalists, when you guys become experts, I'm sure journalism will be a much, much better place, much, much better than today. Hope to hear from you. Thank you for your patience. Jai Hind.